Thanks, Marco. So hello, everyone. My name is Ray Van Hoeklum. So I want to start out this presentation by asking everyone, and this is going to be a poll question, how do you say the name of our province? So I'm going to open up the poll here, just one moment, and then you can provide us, select what you think is the answer for this question. So it's open if everybody can, if you can provide us with your answer. I'll give you a few seconds here to.
So it says the poll ended, right?
Oh, did it? Okay, yeah. Sorry. I'm not sure.
Do you want to launch that one again?
Sure. I'll just do share results, stop sharing, and let's try this one more time here. Relaunch poll. Oh, there we go. Okay. Perfect.
Perfect. It looks like
there. Now, sorry. Now you can select the answer that you think is correct. Looks like perfect. We got everyone has answered by the looks. I'm going to close it down now and let's see the results here. I'm going to share them here. So it looks like majority of everybody picked the first one. So you know what, that is correct. It is Saskatchewan, so Saskatchewan. So now I'll just stop sharing that. And so I am the Senior International Policy Advisor with the Government of Saskatchewan, the Ministry of Advanced Education. I want to welcome everyone to here today. My colleagues from the Saskatchewan Post-Secondary Institutions and myself will be speaking to you about the opportunities of studying in Saskatchewan. And again, so I have another poll question for you to answer. And that is, where is the province of Saskatchewan located in Canada? So here again, I am going to launch another poll question. So if you can select the answer or select one of the options, and then I'll close it down here within a few seconds. I'll give you a little bit of time here. Okay, I'm gonna end the poll now and let's see here. I'll share results. So it looks like majority said between the provinces of Ontario and Quebec. Okay, so, well, Saskatchewan is in fact located in the central part of Canada. We are in the prairies of Canada and we are a province of more than a million people. We are in the perfect location because we can travel to Vancouver or even travel to Toronto in the same amount of time. Our students are happy and healthy here because they can travel and visit many places in Canada because we are located in the center part of Canada and have access to both sides of Canada, east and western side. Saskatchewan has absolutely the greatest places to study. So again, I have, for me, there's one more poll question I have for you to answer. And I will bring that up here right now. Okay, here we go. And I'm gonna launch it and I'll give you another 20 seconds about or so to respond to the question here. So what makes Saskatchewan great? Is it because we have a world-class education, or maybe it's the thriving economy and employment we have here, the incredible quality of life, great immigration policies, or would you say all of the above? Okay, I'm going to thank you for your responses. I'm going to close the poll now and let's just see the results here. So it looks like every majority said all of the above that makes Saskatchewan a great place. So now I'm going to talk to you about the top five reasons why you should come and study in Saskatchewan. First of all, we have everything you need here to succeed in our province. We have a world-class education from PhD programs to master degree programs, undergraduate programs, diploma and certificate programs. Our institutions here are really top rank in the world. Our public institutions provide support to all students. We have a thriving economy. Students in our public institutions have access to the postgraduate work permit program. In addition, our institutions offer work integrated learning, such as the co-op placement and internships. Plus, students can work part-time on or off campus while attending full-time studies. Saskatchewan had an unemployment rate of 6.3% compared to the Canadian average rate of 8.2% in May of 2021. We also have tremendous wages as well. We are very competitive as a province and very stable when it comes to employment and the economy. Our province has an incredible quality of life. We offer clean air and scenic provincial parks. We have healthcare for all our students, and students can receive the COVID-19 vaccination for free. And then we also have the immigration policies, great immigration policies here. The government of Saskatchewan is looking for talented people to come and make Saskatchewan their home. So today I'm going to give you a brief introduction to our Saskatchewan post-secondary institutions. So the first institution that I'm going to introduce you to is the University of Saskatchewan, which is one of the most historic institutions in Canada. They have 25,000 students from 132 countries. They have about 58 kinds of degrees, diplomas, and certificates. And also they are part of the U15 membership school in Canada. And next, I'd like to introduce you to the University of Regina. The university has approximately 16,000 students from about 50 countries from the world. It has been ranked one of the top 200 best universities, young universities in the world. It is a dynamic institution and has 10 faculties and 25 academic departments. And now the next institution I'd like to introduce you to is the Saskatchewan Polytechnic. Polytechnic is the leading technical education and skills training institution in Saskatchewan. It is career focused, employer driven, and hands-on learning opportunities is available to all the students. They have approximately 150 certificate and diploma programs in small campuses across our province. And finally, but not least, we have the regional colleges located in the vibrant and welcoming small communities throughout the province. These colleges offer high quality studies in very small environments with about 40 students or less per classroom. It is friendly and a relaxed atmosphere, and the programs are really tailored so students can get a job after graduation. And now I just want to share a little bit of my experience growing up and attending one of the five regional colleges in rural Saskatchewan. So living in rural Saskatchewan, in which I grew up there, I felt a great sense of community and I felt safe within my community. I would never think twice about walking down a street and stopping to talk to whoever passed by me. And I usually knew who those people were, just because it was such a friendly, small community. Everybody knows each other and they look out for you, whether you want them or not to, but it's such a great atmosphere. And then I also had neighbors that would watch out for me and help me out when I needed it as well. And then I attended the Southeast College, which is one of the five regional colleges in Saskatchewan, and I took the administrative assistant certificate program there. And I like to say the instructors at the college were always there to provide support and answer all my questions when I needed it. So with that said, I would like to now pass it over to Danny. To provide you more detail and in-depth conversation about the University of Saskatchewan. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Ray. And can you hear me okay? Can you give me a thumbs up? Okay, perfect. Thank you so much for that, Chrissy. This is a picture of the beautiful campus of the University of Saskatchewan located in Saskatoon. The university is leading the way of tackling the most pressing problems like water and food security. Research, teaching and learning at University of Saskatchewan is enhanced by our array of world-class centers and facilities. The community that lives here, Ray already mentioned earlier, it's about 25,700 students with more than 3,000 international students. And our diverse students, staff, and faculty create a welcoming community where different perspectives are valued and a culture of learning, growth, and deeper understanding extends beyond the classroom. As you can see, the University of Saskatchewan is one of the top U15 research universities, which is the medical doctoral research intensive category out of 96 institutions in all of Canada. In addition, the university is ranked, in the next slide please, Ring, is ranked among the top 200 universities in the world in a variety of categories. Just to highlight a couple of interesting ones would be, of course, water resources, as I mentioned earlier, also around the public administration, environmental sciences and engineering, food science and technology, earth sciences, and many, many other things. This is not the only thing the university does. I'll stop there for one quick second before I continue. Ray, can you please launch the poll question? If you don't mind answering the question of why would so many international students be interested in the University of Saskatchewan, that would be really helpful. Beautiful winter weather, yes. We have well-ranked and excellent programs, and it's a small institution. Interesting, we're gonna close it here in a little bit. Ray, if you can end the poll. Yeah, so the University of Saskatchewan, as I already mentioned, is well-ranked and has excellent programs, which takes me to my next slide. Ray, please, the next slide. Thank you so much. The University of Saskatchewan counts with its own language center where we offer English academic preparation for undergraduate and graduate students. But as you can see, we offer a range of excellent programs from business, arts, humanities. We have also education, we have engineering and kinesiology. In addition to that, Ray, if you can go to the next slide, please. We also offer things like dentistry, medicine, veterinary medicine, nutrition, pharmacy, nursing, and so on. You can notice here that medicine is grayed out. And the reason for that is because in the future, this will be the only college that does not accept international students. All of the rest of the colleges will welcome international students. But first, you have to go to the direct entry colleges before you decide to pursue one of these careers with us. Next slide, please, Ray. The university at various levels offers a variety of opportunities for students to participate in co-ops, internships, and research experiences. And this matches the academic interests of students and gives you as a student the opportunity for that hands-on learning that allows you to expand your knowledge beyond the classroom. We offer a wide range of scholarships, if you can go to the next slide. For students and specifically international students, and encourage you to apply early to be able to access some of these scholarships. I'm going to pause there for a second. And Ray, can you please show the poll the next question, please? Excellent. Just out of my own curiosity, I would like to know what programs are you interested in studying in the future? Business economics, excellent. Arts, humanities, and culture, engineering. Wow, wow. A great variety, a great mix. Environmental, animal, human. English programs, yeah, absolutely. Thank you so much. We'll close the poll right away here, Ray. And given the great range of interests that you have, all of these scholarships allow you to pursue any of those interests, especially when we're thinking about arts, humanities, and culture, which is something university is also well known for, in addition to everything else that we offer. If you can go to the last slide, please, Ray. The main campus of the University of Saskatchewan is located in Saskatoon, Saskatchewan, Canada. the benefits of living and studying in Canada are well known. And Ray already did an excellent job at telling you about the province of Saskatchewan and choosing us as a research and study destination. It's always good to keep in mind. Saskatoon, from my perspective, has all the amenities that any student would like to have, and the warmth of the people is always something that makes me happy. I have been here for over 20 years, and I can tell you that it's an awesome experience to have gone from being a student to working and now promoting and telling you the opportunities that exist here. Thank you so much. I'm going to pass it over to my colleagues. At the U of R, sorry.
Thank you, Danny. Hello, everyone. My name is Ashley. It's my pleasure to be joining you today. I'm going to be sharing with you what makes the University of Regina a great choice for your international education. So Ray, if you wouldn't mind changing the slide. Great. So we are located in the city of Regina. It is the capital city of Saskatchewan and has a population of around 250,000 people. In 2021, Regina was ranked as one of the top 20 best communities to live in Canada. Commonly referred to as the Queen City, Regina offers many exciting activities throughout the year and is welcoming to international students. Next slide, please. So you should choose the U of R because we can provide you a high quality education and student support in an environment where you're not just a number. So you matter to us and we'll do everything we can to ensure you are successful. As Ray mentioned, we are large enough to host students from over 60 countries, yet we're small enough to give you a more personalized and focused academic experience. Our beautiful modern campus in Wascana Park offers the perfect environment for you to study and relax. And as one of the top 15 comprehensive universities in Canada, and we are also the top research university by InfoSource in 2020. You'll definitely be learning from the best. And next slide, please. So the U of R offers a wide range of programs, so there's really something for everybody. We offer the four-year undergraduate degrees as well as two-year diplomas and one-year certificates. At the postgraduate level, we have some master's programs and select PhDs. So you can see our faculties listed here with some of the most popular majors of study. So just to highlight a few, for the Faculty of Arts, they offer most of the diploma and certificate options that we have. For business, they do the bachelor degree as well as the diploma if you want a shorter program. Education is a really great choice if you're interested in staying in Saskatchewan after your studies, and it also includes an internship as part of your degree program. For engineering, we have five different majors to choose from and some really great state-of-the-art labs and facilities for you to complete your projects. And for kinesiology and health studies, offers the programs in recreation, wellness, health, and sport. Next slide, please. For media, art, and performance is our fine arts faculty. A standout major we have is the film production major, and that can be taken as a degree or diploma and is actually the only program of its kind between Toronto and Vancouver. Science offers many majors. It's one of our biggest faculties. Most popular, I would say, computer science major, which can also be taken as a degree or a diploma. We have faculty of social work and nursing, which are more specialized degree programs. So they have a very large practical and clinical element. Center for Continuing Education offers our short-term programs. We also have La Cité, which is our French language college for any students interested in studying the second official language of Canada. And lastly, as I mentioned, our Faculty of Graduate Studies and Research offers our master's and PhD programs. So students can focus on thesis, coursework, or project-based program while enjoying some of the lowest graduate tuition fees in the country. Next slide, please. So something we are really proud of is our cooperative education program. So this program allows you to take part in paid internships throughout your studies so that you can earn money while getting valuable work experience. So many of our students even receive job offers from the organization where they complete their internship. So we can go to our first poll question, Ray, and it is, the question is, what is the average amount that you could earn per month during a co-op work placement? So we have a few options to choose from here. So this would be the monthly average salary. So just give it a few seconds. Great, so we can just close that out. So actually the answer is 3,200. So most of you thought it was the 2,000 or 1,000. So such a great opportunity for international students to earn while you learn. And we can just go to the next slide. So we do have some special scholarships for international students. And one of them is the entrance scholarship. So all international students who enter with a GPA of 85% or more can receive their choice of either $3,000 in tuition credit or 8 months of residence at the university. Our solidarity scholarship of $1,000 is also available to new students starting in the fall 2021 or winter 2022 terms. And these ones are automatically awarded, but there are also many other scholarships students can apply for through the U of R scholarship database. And just next slide, please. So our tuition is calculated based on how many classes you take per semester and which faculty you are in. So the average prices are listed here for 1 year, and you are able to pay on a semester basis, so you don't have to pay everything all at once. The average price for on-campus living is $800 per month. Regina is one of the most affordable cities in Canada, so you'll still be able to have fun on a student's budget. Next slide. So here you can see that we have modern and comfortable residences where you can choose from dorm or apartment style accommodations. So your home away from home will provide you with furnished and safe living space just steps away from class. And the best part about living on campus is all of the events and activities to enjoy and meeting people from all over the world. Next slide. So if you would like to apply, it's very easy to submit an online application and upload your supporting documents. And if you don't have your English proficiency test yet, we can still issue the conditional letter of acceptance if you meet the academic requirements. And I'd also like to mention, we do offer some qualifying programs in certain faculties, as well as transfer credit evaluation. Next slide. And there are a number of ways that you can meet the English requirement through one of the approved tests listed here or through previous education. And there's also some countries that are exempt from providing the English test. And some students who do not meet the requirements, they actually may be interested in studying our English as a second language program at the U of R, which is in the next slide. So our ESL academic program, it's offered in 5 skill levels and takes 1 semester to complete each level. ESL provides really high quality English training and small class sizes so you can succeed in your studies. And the unique ESL plus one program allows students in advanced EAP level to actually take one undergraduate class while completing their ESL program. So you get a best of both worlds kind of situation. Just the next slide, please. So a bit about our international student services. Many of our advisors were international students themselves, and they're now helping others transition to life in Canada. So we offer many things such as an airport welcome, an exciting orientation, immigration guidance, and social events. So we can just go to our second poll question, Ray, if you wouldn't mind. So the poll question is, what services do University of Regina students have access to? So we have a bunch of different services listed here. And some of the ones I mentioned specifically, we have really strong immigration guidance, academic support, counseling, free bus pass as well, included in your tuition fees. So many of you are correct there. The answer is all of the above. So you'll definitely be well supported as an international student. Okay, so just the next slide, right? So when you're here studying at the U of R, you have so many opportunities to get involved, and your university experience, it's not just about academics, but also about having fun and growing as a person. So there are many student clubs and societies and sports teams to join, as well as unique experiences such as dancing at the Welcome Week party, attending faculty gala, or learning about Indigenous people at our First Nations University powwow every year. So our campus really embraces diversity, and there's always something exciting going on. And just the last slide, please, Ray. So in closing, the University of Regina is a really great choice for your international experience. If you have any questions, you can always reach out to us in the ways listed here, and I encourage you to follow us on social media so you can see what we're up to. So thank you so much for listening, and we hope to see you on campus soon. Thank you and stay safe.
Hello, everybody. I'm Vishesh Patel, and I'm representing Saskatchewan Polytechnic, and I'm a graduate of Saskatchewan Polytechnic as an international student from the business management program in 2015. I hope today's session will help you as well, and I'll talk about Saskatchewan Polytechnic uniqueness and its advantages, list of programs that we offer, and support services. Ray, can you put the poll question one here, please? Just want to know how many students know about this. Right, so here's a question. So if you can answer that. Yeah, a lot of them are correct here. All right, so I think we can stop sharing. Yeah, so most of you are correct here. So 94% is our employment rate within 6 months to 1 year after graduation. So that should be good. So yeah, I'll talk about on the next slide here is Saskatchewan Polytechnic advantages. So there are so many reasons to join Saskatchewan Polytechnic. First of all, it's a public institution and it's the largest college in Saskatchewan. We have close connections with the industry, and each program has a program advisory council that comprises of industry representatives. They review curriculum annually to ensure what we teach is as relevant as possible to employment market. New programs undergo a rigorous approval process that concludes with approval from the Provincial Ministry of Education. And the key part of approval process is ensuring there are jobs for graduates. We have small class size, that is from 25 to 30 students in class, that makes it easy to know your peers and have instructors know you by name and ask questions freely. Saskatchewan Polytechnic is great and for that, and allows you to get that one-on-one support in the classroom. Hands-on learning opportunities let you apply what you learn in your classrooms and in the real world situation, and you gain your job ready skills that you require upon graduation to get the job. Tuition is affordable. The average tuition cost per year is around $17,000, and you can find the tuition cost for each program on our website, including with an estimate of books and supplies. And the bottom three circles here are from the surveys that we do every year. And I would like to emphasize again that 94% of the graduates get the jobs within 6 months to 1 year after graduation. Next slide, please. We have 11 faculties here. So, and all the faculties offer programs to international students. We have four campuses located in four major cities in Saskatchewan, that is Saskatoon, Regina, Prince Albert, and Moose Jaw. So that gives you flexibility to select the campus depending on which program you want to study. And I would like to have my second poll question here to. So here is a question. So how many programs are offered to international students? All right, so we can stop the poll now. Yeah, there is, so most of you are correct here. So we have more than 70 programs that we offer to international students. And I'd like to add more here on this next slide. I'll show you all like what options we have for you all. So these are alphabetically arranged here for you if you want to take a look. But there are more than 70 programs that we offer to international students, and around 50 of which are undergraduate programs in most of the streams, and about 10 are post-graduation certificate programs. There are programs with co-op options that helps you getting your work experience and apply your skills in real work situations. Each program has a program length, so most of them are between 1 to 3 years of the program length. So we do offer shorter programs compared to most of the university programs, and each program has their own specific requirements for the admission. I would like to highlight a few programs. Here is a business diploma program that has a co-op option and will allow you to work with the industry leaders during the co-op work term. And so some of our science programs like chemical technology diploma program has a pathway to University of Regina and University of Saskatchewan that are present here today. And there are many other programs that has pathways to many other universities in Canada. There are new programs that are launched last year is, post-graduation program is artificial intelligence, cloud computing, and blockchain. And those are emerging fields, not only in Saskatchewan, but all over Canada and around the world. We offer program bundling options that allow students to be accepted into two programs with one application form, one following another, and they receive one acceptance letter covering the time period for both the programs. So I hope you have noted this slide here that will give you program options. We'll move on to the next slide here. So this slide, so we make sure that there are students having smooth transitions to arrive and settle their life in Canada and in Saskatchewan. So we do offer a wide range of support services that help, that will help you. And I will encourage you to take advantage of these services. The first one I would like to mention here is the child care centers that are located at Prince Albert, Saskatoon, and Regina campuses. We have employment services that provides you assistance with writing resumes, cover letters, and interview preparations. There are international advisor team available at each campus that can advise you in situations or questions like pre-arrival information. If your questions like how many hours can I work during summer, quarantine arrangements, or anything else that comes to your mind. We also have counseling services that completely is confidential. And if you have, if you're having any academic or personal issues, then you can help that you need help dealing with them, and they are here to help you. So I would be happy to on the next slide, please. And then this is our contact information. So I'll be happy to answer any other questions that you have. You can email us directly at international@saspolytech.ca. And thank you. I'll pass on to our next regional colleges. Thank you.
Thanks, Vishnesh. I am Christy Sletton, and I represent the Regional Colleges of Saskatchewan. I really enjoy actually presenting last because it allows me to highlight, of course, some of the amazing options available in our province and include the regional colleges as part of that esteemed group. So the regional or the province of Saskatchewan, as you can see, has developed an excellent regional college system. And this system is a complement to many of the post-secondary options already available in the province. The regional college system offers some excellent opportunities for our international students. And in fact, I always like to tell students that many of the things that the regional college system offers are a perfect fit for what international students are looking for. And I'll explain more in a bit. Next slide, Ray. So the regional college system in the province of Saskatchewan. Oh, sorry, Ray, I'm going to get you to go back one. There we go. Yeah. So the regional college system in the province of Saskatchewan was developed to ensure that education was accessible in as many parts of the province as possible. So our campus locations are outside of Saskatchewan's main cities and in our smaller centers. Now, sometimes this is a point of concern for students because they believe that living in a small community won't provide them with the opportunities that they would have in a larger center. But what I will say is that the province of Saskatchewan has used immigration widely to try to fill skilled work opportunities, as well as our post-secondary institutions. So in each of the communities where our regional colleges exist, there is many different opportunities for international students. recreationally, socially, academically, and for work. So certainly an option that we encourage you to look at. So as I said, the regional college system does provide a very nice fit for some of the things that international students are looking for. When international students travel to a new country and a new education system to study in, sometimes they require a little bit more support than the average student. The regional college system is committed to student success, and there are a multitude of options for students to get support, either with specific academic opportunities or language support or any of those areas where they might require a little bit of additional assistance. But over and above that, there is lots of support for students as they settle and make a life for themselves in our regional college cities. Secondly, the opportunity for students to gain employment while they study, but also after they're done, certainly is intense. There are many opportunities for students to work while they study, part-time employment, and the opportunities for students, as I said, are vast once they're done as well. The regional colleges in the province that are designated currently are Cumberland College, Northwest College, Great Plains College, Parkland College, and Southeast College, all listed on the map. So Ray, maybe we'll get a poll question now. So what is the top factor that you think would make your international education experience the most rewarding? Ray, can we close that? Perfect. Yeah, so a mixture of things there, and certainly all things that are offered by the regional college system. Okay, next slide. So I'll talk a little bit about the three colleges that are accepting students for the September 21 school year. Cumberland College is located in the northeast part of Saskatchewan and really offers students the opportunity to live in a very beautiful part of the province with many parks and lakes and really scenic destinations. So Cumberland College offers the following programs that you can see on the screen there. And all of these programs are postgraduate work permit eligible. Next slide. Parkland College is the second college that is accepting students for the September 2021 school year. Parkland College has been in the international education sphere for many, many years now and offers many programs for students in the areas shown. Parkland College is located in the east central part of Saskatchewan. For the most part in the city of Yorkton. Next slide. Great Plains College is located in north central as well as the southwest corner of Saskatchewan. Great Plains College takes pride in having some of the best scholarship programs available to international students. Currently, Great Plains College offers the following programs. So Northwest College and Southeast College will have programming starting in September 2022. So keep an eye out for what they will have on offer. So one of the things that I wanted to just quickly mention about the regional college system is that we are a brokerage system, which means that access programs from other credit granting institutions. So many of the programs at the regional colleges are brokered from Saskatchewan Polytechnic. So we take pride in the fact that, we use programs from this esteemed institution. So the opportunity for students to get a certificate or diploma from one of the regional colleges actually means that that certification would be coming from Saskatchewan Polytechnic for the most part. There are a few other institutions that we do broker from, which do vary from institution to institution. The differences of the regional college system in comparison to some of our counterparts in the province are our small class sizes, which you've already heard, the opportunity for students to study in classes less than 24 students is something that the regional college takes pride in. As Vishnesh mentioned, the small class size really does allow international students to get that level of support that's required, as well as developing that level of comfort that's necessary to advocate for themselves in the classroom. The regional college system, as a philosophy, has a very strong focus on skills for the workforce. So the opportunity for students to gain some of those soft skills and work on, the skills that are necessary for success in the workforce is really built right into the programs at each of the regional colleges. One of the other things that I believe is a benefit of the regional college system is the fact that the communities in which the regional colleges exist really promote a strong sense of community for students who are coming to us from different countries. So the small community feeling in the province of Saskatchewan really is something that is a benefit to international students, as it does allow them to build that support system much more quickly and effectively. And finally, the regional college system does boast a very low cost for students, both in the realm of tuition, but also in the cost of living. The smaller centers in Saskatchewan certainly do have a lower cost of living overall for students, which again is something that's really a nice fit for the international student population. Okay, let's go with another poll question if we could, Ray. So here we're going to talk a little bit about the topic that no one wants to talk about, which is winter. And let's see what winter activity you think you might like to try. Okay, Ray, can we close that? Fantastic. It looks like there's interest in all of them. And, although the winter is certainly something that, some students fear, what I will say is that the opportunity to participate in winter activities does provide for some really exciting and unique experiences for international students. So certainly don't fear the winter. It is an opportunity to experience something pretty amazing. Okay, next slide. So I would like to just close by saying that, you have heard from all of our partners, partner institutions in Saskatchewan, and the regional colleges really do provide a viable option for students to have a great place to study, to work, and to live. Saskatchewan's smaller cities are full of amazing opportunities for international students in many different arenas, as I've spoken about. The Saskatchewan Immigrant Nominee Program, or SINP, provides great pathways to permanent residence in the province. And again, the regional college communities do offer economical opportunities for students, excellent education, and work opportunities, both in their preparation for work, as well as once they're done their program. So last poll question. So would you be interested in pursuing permanent residence in Canada after you graduate? Okay, Ray, can we close that? And perfect. Well, one of the beauties of international education is that we get to capitalize on some of the amazing people around the world and draw them to Saskatchewan and have them be employed and live with us for well into the future. So I would like to encourage you to go and seek out any of the regional colleges on the internet. Each of us maintains vast websites that will provide lots of information about the programs, the communities, and the opportunities within each of the areas in the province. Thank you very much.
Great. Thank you for joining us today as we speak about studying in Saskatchewan. I just quickly wanted to let you know that the government of Saskatchewan, the study in Saskatchewan, we have a booth here at the fair. So I would encourage you to come and visit us and we can provide you with further information if you require. Again, thank you. And Marco, I'm not sure, do we have some time to answer
unfortunately,
questions?
Or... unfortunately, we're exactly at the time. But like Ray mentioned, they do have a booth in the exhibit hall, so go check them out there. They'll be here all day. So your questions are not too far away to being answered if you can't get them here. Other than that, I hope everyone had enjoyed their time, and we look forward to seeing you all on the platform. Thank you, everyone.
Great. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.